Hello, welcome to this tutorials on programming computational fluid dynamics. My name is Saurabh. Before we start writing our CFD code, let me try to first justify why am I using Java for computational fluid dynamics. When deciding upon a language for CFD programming, Java is not the language which first comes to mind. In fact, some of my professors do not like to use Java for CFD programming. The reason for such a thought is not whether Java is appropriate for CFD or not. It is because Java has not been used in CFD community by many people. It is Fortran or C which is being used, and recently C++ is preferred. The main reason for using these languages is reusability of existing legacy codes which were written long time ago, and these codes are known to be robust and efficient. However, the problem with such codes is that they are not easy to maintain or extend to add functionality. The modern way of programming is to use object-oriented programming with the use of abstraction wherever possible to make the code as maintainable and reusable as possible. Also, cross-platform execution, speed of execution and development time are important aspects to be considered. Three programming languages come to my mind which can be used for modern CFD programming. They are C++, Python and Java. Let us compare Java to C++ and then compare Java with Python to justify the selection of Java. I know that many people will not agree with my thoughts. If so, please leave a comment. Let us start by comparing Java with C++. Java runs almost as fast as C++ based on the benchmark tests available on internet and also based on my own experience. The speed of execution of Java programs is not an issue. In most cases, performance of Java compared to C++ is not less than 90%. Secondly, I like the collections classes in Java more than C++, like the list and set. In CFD codes, handling data like geometry and fluid flow properties in an efficient way is very crucial. The collections class in Java is very intuitive to use and very elaborate, allowing to do complex tasks like sorting, removing duplicate elements, etc. very easily. The collections classes automatically scale to parallel programming in shared memory systems using parallel streams recently introduced in Java 8. Even otherwise, the collection class is very efficient and very well tested over last two decades. Programming for a parallel cluster using MPI is very similar in Java to C++ using a library called MPJ Express. Also, many libraries for GPGPU programming are available if one intends to use GPUs for speeding up their code. The only one shortcoming of Java compared to C++ which I know about is the memory consumption. In Java, objects use more memory compared to C++, and as such, the memory consumption of Java programs is more compared to C++. However, with current computers, this is no more an issue as we normally have a lot of RAM, and to run moderate size problems, it is not an issue anymore. And for large problems, we will anyways be using clusters with distributed localized memory. Now, let us compare Java with Python. In the current scenario, interpreted and scripting languages like Python are not suitable for a full-fledged CFD codes due to the slowness of execution. Python has very good libraries for collections which are comparable to Java. Also, the library for numerical computations called NumPy is very good. However, I personally do not like dynamically typed languages for programming large softwares, as they are prone to errors and failures, as type checking is done only at runtime. Especially for large codes, this is a big issue, as type checking is not automatically done by compiler. Statically typed languages like Java and C++ are more preferable, as the compiler, that is the IDE, can point out the possible errors at the time of writing program itself. Currently, just-in-time compilation libraries are under development for Python, like PyPy and Numba, which may be able to make Python suitable for CFD programming in future. But the dynamic nature of the language still stops me from using Python. A programming language is finally just a tool to tell the computer what needs to be done in the most precise way. Therefore, the main focus is on the methods to be used for CFD and not the programming language. It is generally trivial to convert codes from one programming language to another. For example, recently I converted a complex Fortran code to Java in just few hours. Java and C++ have very similar syntax, to the extent that it is difficult to tell the difference in first look. And converting between these languages is very easy. On the other hand, converting from Java to C or Fortran is difficult due to the additional features of Java which are not existing in these languages, like use of objects. If you choose to program along with me during the course of these tutorials, it does not matter as to which language you use for programming. The ideas and concepts are going to remain the same, immaterial of the language used. Use of Java or C++ is, however, preferred, as it will be more convenient. Finally, I hope we have a great time programming CFD software in coming videos. So see you soon.